Here's how to run an inference server or object detection server from your Tinker HT. The first thing you'll have to do is open a port in your router settings. I'm in mine now, and you can see that the Tinker HT is connected to my network with an IP address of 10.0.0.181. That's going to be our server IP. And then you also have to open up a web port for the device, which is 4664. Every router menu will be different, so navigating through this will be different on yours, but all you need is to open up that port. Therefore, in order to connect to the server, the address will be 10.0.0.181:4664. Keep that in the back of your mind as we now switch to the Tinker HT to set up the server. I'm going to keep Mendel and Windows side by side. First off, let's go to the folder that has all our detection models. I think I put mine in CD, Home, Mendel, Examples Camera, All Models. Yep, that's the list of all of our models. We'll keep this in our back pocket for now, and this is the first config item we need. Next, we need to find the location of our camera. We did this in the previous video, but here it is again. We do that with V4L2 CTL list devices. You can see our webcam is plugged in to Dev Video 2, and it's a Logitech C922. The next config item we need is the compatible video format, resolution, and frame rate. And to find that, we use V4L2 CTL again, and we'll add the following parameters: -D, which is the directory, so that's Dev Video 2, and list formats extension more. You can see that we have the YUYV or YUY2 video format in the following resolutions and frame rates like 640 by 480 at 30 FPS. And then there's these other ones here further down. And there's even an MJPEG video format and these resolutions to go with it. For now, let's just use YUY2 640 by 480 at 30 FPS. That's going to be the next config item we need to remember. So we'll put this all together now, which means we can run a built-in script in the Tinker HT called EdgeTPU Detect Server. And the arguments we have to provide for this are model. Let's use the MobileNet SSD V2 CocoQuant post-process EdgeTPU. And finally, the video source we need is source Dev Video 2 : YUY2 : 640 by 480 : 30/1. And when we run that, you can see it's listening for devices to connect to port 4665, 64, and 66. We've enabled 4664 in our router settings before, so all we have to do is type in that IP and port into a browser, and there I am. I can even open that IP address on my phone. And you can see that two devices are connected to the object detection server. How cool is that? All right, that's the end of these basic Tinker HT tutorials. I hope you're feeling way more comfortable with using the board now. If you've liked this series, then please hit the like and subscribe button, because not only does it help me out, but you'll know straight away when I upload more Tinker HT videos. I'm planning to do tutorials on how to build your own TensorFlow Lite EdgeTPU model with transfer learning, and I'll explain how I built my license plate app on the Tinker HT. You won't want to miss those, because that's the really awesome, powerful stuff that everyone wants to learn. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you in another video. See you later.